thrilled to have the boys and girls here in such big numbers. We have the Feast of St. Nicholas, which we'll celebrate December 6th. But what we've asked the children at the beginning of Mass is to give us one of their shoes. Because on the Feast of Nicholas, St. Nicholas comes, you might know him as Santa Claus, comes and he puts little treats into your shoe, but first you need a shoe. So the shoes in the back, and the elves will bring them after communion. It's a symbol of the sweetness of the Lord. It reminds us that the church calendar is a calendar of meaning. And our regular calendar is a calendar of sales and half price, a lot of things, discounts and whatnot. But we want meaning. Yeah, we want toys. We want things like that. But we want to know, what are we celebrating anyways? Here today, a wonderful opportunity for us is one of the little sisters of the poor, Sister Frances. Now, these are nuns. Now, nuns are women who are very holy. Only when they dress with a very pretty veil on their head. And what do? Some people get married, some people stay single, some people get ordained to priesthood, and some people become nuns or deacons. The nuns are really, in effect, brides of Christ. They're married to Jesus, which is wonderful. Now, my aunt was a nun, and they used to say to my grandfather, you have the best son-in-law, Jesus. It's a beautiful opportunity to see a woman who dedicates her entire life to the gospel. Now, Sister's going to come in just a second to speak, but I wanted to tell you beforehand about this railing that we put around the pulpit. What happened was people would come to weddings, and very nervous about letting them all dressed up, and usually the ladies with really high heels. They fall off their shoes all the time, and they were falling off the pulpit. They'd say the word of the Lord, boom, boom, boom. And it makes me a nervous wreck during weddings. So what we did was I looked for this pulpit, and it's from the Church of St. Casimir in New Haven, which closed about 15 years ago. It was a Lithuanian church. And this church, our church, St. Margaret Mary, was built on a Lithuanian farm. This used to be the Kaptunas farm. So I think the Lithuanians are very happy with this. We had parishioners and neighbors who donate their talent to make sure that the metal was clean. It was wood before, they said, no, let's match the marble. So they did all of it. It was about $1,500 pre. So, you know, that's how we roll. So the boys and girls, why is it important that we be up here in a dignified spot? Because it's significant. You have story time at bedtime. We have story time during the day, which we like very much. These stories are the stories of meaning, the meaning of Jesus. And now Sister's going to come up and speak, Sister Frances. And when a sister speaks to Catholics, we all sit up straight. Sister?
Good morning. I'm very happy to be here. I've never been here before. It's a beautiful church, beautiful singing. I wish I could take her home and she could help us. We're pretty bad. I'm mesmerized by her voice. Many of you may know the little sisters. You may have been to our home in Enfield, Connecticut. We have 80 residents. We have several priests, three priests. We have seven couples, which is really unusual. We have one Father Golas, his father is coming in, and now his mother is coming in, so that'll make a seventh couple. And we are really for the poor. We try to take them in our home and surround them with as much love as possible. We cannot take the place of their family, but we try to do all that we can for them. And just like you're celebrating the Feast of St. Nicholas, we did it yesterday in our home. And years ago, I was in one home, and the residents put their shoes outside of their door, and then we went around and filled them. But one of the residents was hobbling around the room. She fell and broke her hip. So we don't do that anymore. So we had a sale yesterday where the residents could come down and buy things for their family and save it all year long when people give up. And so we give them $250 in paper money. But listen to the stories. They think that money is real. They came down and they buy things and then they give us the money and then we give them the change. And sometimes they argue with us that it's not the right change. One lady came back, she wanted to turn some back, she wanted her money back. I said, it's only play money. But they really get into buy for their grandchildren. I think some of them buy for themselves, too. But it was just wonderful to see. And then we had about 20 young women, young girls, helping us. We have a hospitality club of children that come to the home after 10 years old and up. And so they each one took one of the residents. And so they were buying things. So it was just a beautiful time for our residents. And you could see the joy, and they were all so happy. And we had hats that lit up, and they all wanted one of those. You could tell the favorite things. So that's what we as little sisters are about, to give joy to our residents, that they're not just there existing in our home. But one of the most important works of a little sister is to be with the residents when they are dying. We have a fourth vow called hospitality, and that is what that vow is. So when a resident is dying, a little sister is always there, holding their hand, accompanying them. The family is present, they're very much a part of the process. So they're not afraid to die because they know a little sister will be there. And I'm a nurse first. For many years I did nursing. And I had one man that I could see that he was dying. We get used to it, we can tell. And I said, Charlie, I think your days are coming very near the end. And he said, whatever you do, don't call the priest. Hadn't been to the church for 42 years. So I was a very young sister, full of enthusiasm, and I was praying, and I made that, I don't know if you ever, I made a 9-hour novena. Every hour I'd say this prayer. I'm walking around the house saying this novena. But 2 hours before he died, he said to me, he called me and said, all right, Sister Francis, you got your way. Call the priest, just like that. I was so excited. He came back and made his confession, received communion, that's, you know, the last rite. And his son was a deacon in the church. They hadn't talked for years because he became a deacon. They reconciled, and then he died very peacefully, you know, with no struggle at all, because he was at peace. He finally reached peace. So that's what we really try, to make our residents happy, to make them peaceful. So we have a lot of things that go on. And I was 21 years of Albany, New York, and when I first came 2 years ago, my superior said to me, we need a bus. And she said, it's about $80,000. I was here 2 days. She said, I know you can do it. So I had a jazz brunch, and I did golf tournament and all kinds of things, and we were able to get the bus because our residents are just like you. They want to go out. They want to go shopping. They go to the dollar store once a week. I don't know. Come back with these gigantic bags. I don't know what they buy, but anyway. And then she said to me, this year, we need 535 windows replaced. You know, about $600,000. We have about $200,000 because our windows, if you open them, you can't close them. The residents have Walmart bags because the cool air is coming in. They're crumbling. So we're in the process of getting bids to replace our window. So if any of you want to get a window in memory of somebody, you know, give us $500. But if you only want a cap, just put your initials. But because we want our home to be warm, we want our, you know, we can feed and clothe our residents, but we also want them to be warm. So I ask you to pray also for vocations. We have 195 homes in the world, and we just opened a new home in Peru. Last night we saw a movie about the sisters starting home in Peru. They only have two residents as of now, but they're just starting. We're opening another home in Africa because that's where the poor really are, and they really need the little sisters. So there's no vocations in Australia, Spain, or Ireland. So the last profession we had to send a sister to Ireland and one to Spain. So we need vocations. And last month we had 3 girls injured, and we have 195 homes. So we ask you to pray for that. I do a lot with vocations, and I'm working with a couple of girls now. But one in the back of the church, and she said, I'm discerning, she said, but I don't know if I want to take care of the elderly. And she said, because I can't give up my cell phone. I said, I have one. Her eyes got all big. And she said, well, I can't give up my boyfriend. He never asks us anything that we can't do because His grace is there. I'm a nurse, and about 20 years ago, my superior asked me if I would do this. I'm the beggar, I'm the collector, I'm the development director of a few other jobs. And I said, but I can't talk in church. I can't get up and give up the talk. And she said, and now the sisters tease me. They said she never stops talking. So pray that the vocation, because it's so important that we can continue our work and take care of our people more. We had to close our home in Albany. We closed the home in Montreal, Evansville, Indiana, Cleveland, St. Louis. But our home in Evansville is a perfect size, it's small, we can handle it. The home in Albany was 6 stories high. We had 200 and some people. We are all 10 sisters in Indiana, but we really run the home. So it has to be a size that we are able to take care of, so I know that you'll remember that. So anyway, you can help us. If you can't, help us by your prayers. Sister will be at that door, and I'll be back there. I told them at the last Mass last night that I would be back there if they meet him early. I'll catch him. And a man left, and I was there, and I said, I had my mask. He said, I don't have any money, sister. And I said, oh, that's all right. We're online. You can donate. It's called We Share. Or I have an envelope here if you want it. He said, I'm never leaving church early again. God taught me. Very much know that the only way we can repay you is by our prayers. And we certainly pray. Because you have kept the little sisters here. 141 years the little sisters have been nothing. In this area, we're 101 years in New Haven and 40 some years in Pittsburgh. So without your help, we couldn't have done it. Because we don't have a parish, we don't have alumni, so we count on the priest that has come and probably put them up for us. I have to say that so they'll let me back again. No, but really and truly, we're very grateful. So many of you people, I know that you're on the mailing list, and you probably will be until after you die, because I won't know if you die. But I appreciate people and all the people in the parishes that we go to. We're truly grateful. Thank you very much. God bless you. By the way, I'm a Yankee fan, too.
Right track. And then the burden.
that. So come Easter. Come Christmas. It's Easter at CBS now.